stepfather one of Chaparral's victims?
Yeah. Kids and cops.
Okay.
Sandy Fonzo's my boy.
Okay. And of course, Sandy kind of became a national figure after the conviction in February. Why was it important for you and other people who experienced Chaparral in the courtroom, sons and daughters of victims, why was it important for you to come out before that?
I just wanted to come out and support her, and I want to see him held accountable for what he did. I mean, a judge should be held to a higher standard, and, you know, he knew what he did was wrong, and now I hope he pays the price for it.
This is only for the extortion. This ain't nothing that for getting your cash. She should be getting driver getting your cash, too.
Talk to me about your son. What kind of kid was he before he got the permission?
Good kid. He was a high school athlete.
Championship wrestler.
Yeah. Like any other kid, got into a little bit of trouble, and it turned into a minor charge, and he was wrongly put away for it. The last thing that's supposed to happen is a kid's taken out of his house and locked up, and that was the first thing that happened to him, and it put him on a downward spiral that ended up with his death.
They're rolling them for nothing.
What do you hope Chaparral is faced with in his sentence today?
I hope he gets life. Whatever amounts to life, whether it's 20 years to life, whatever. I hope he never sees his family again.
Yeah. You know, to me, you get the death penalty.
You know what? Our family, our life is ruined. We're never going to be the same. It's never going to go back to what it was. So I'd like to see that happen for him.
Is Sandy inside?
Yeah, she's the first one in line in the courtroom. Yeah.
Because of her prominence, have you guys been contacted by other local families that have thoughts of the
party? Actually, Sandy started a support group for other families and kids and parents that have been affected by this. And we've gone together for a few meetings just to kind of talk and help each other through it. And they've actually gotten together in preparation for the sentencing. We had a lot of people come in from outside the area just to show support for her and for some of the other families.
You feel like that's helping the other families?
I think it is because they can talk. It's basically the same experience for each family. Kid taken out of the home where they shouldn't have been taken out. And what a lot of people don't realize is these kids are still affected by it. I mean, they may be in their 20s now, but they're still hurting from it.
Her relatives alone, he ended up locking up at least six juveniles alone at her relatives. At least six alone. For nothing. For a fight in school, an argument in school, stuff like that. Six relatives. All from the ages 11 to 15.
It's post-traumatic stress for those kids, and they don't realize how it affects them later on in their choices of their life.
You hoping to see him taken out of cuffs? You don't want to say anything?
I'm not going to say anything. I would love to see him taken out of cuffs. I'm not confident that that's going to happen. I'm sure they let him get his affairs in order, but I would love to see him go out in cuffs.
Anything else to add? That was pretty tight. Let me get the correct spelling here.
My world is turned inside out and upside down and right side up.
How so?
Let's see. I had to go before him for my daughter. A promise that was made, an agreement. Okay, well, first I was threatened that if I didn't be, she didn't be guilty, and if he found her guilty, which he normally does, that she would go to jail until she was 18 years old. So at the age of 14, you don't want this kind of daughter. So I told her, just to put down guilty, we'll try to talk to the court. Well, we walked into a courtroom that was packed like sardines. We were like sardines, we couldn't move. I don't know who these people were, but they weren't defendants. And as I was talking to the judge, they were shackling my daughter, and I didn't realize them until my daughter screamed out. And I turned around and I noticed what they were doing. And even though I tried pleading with him, he told me that if I didn't shut up and get out of this courtroom, that he would have me arrested for contempt of court. And my daughter walked out and was held ever since then.
May I ask your daughter's name?
Bree.
Oh, I'm sorry.
Okay.
Can I get the correct spelling?
It's Bernadine, but I prefer Bree.
Okay, B R I?
B R E.
Okay. Is it Wallace?
Yeah.
How old are you now, Bree?
17.
And you live with your mom in Dallas?
Yeah.
How are you?
How are you guys?
What were you, what were you brought up on charges for?
He's from,
what were you charged with?
An argument on MySpace.
Okay.
ERE.
That's right, that. Gable Hodges, right?
Yep.
That's right.
What happened to Joe Holden?
What was the context of the article? What happened?
You I asked the girl. I don't know who she was. I didn't know her at all. I asked the girl.
She sent this question.
She's trying to go after one of my best friend's boyfriends, and I politely asked her to leave him alone. Stuff escalated from there with name calling and started to get people beat up.
Okay.
I'm sorry?
Stuff escalated from there with name calling and threats to get people beaten up, and her mom decided to print out everything that I said and send it to the Shavertown, Swartzville police station. And they got her entire side of the story. They promised me that I would just get probation, if that, maybe a fine for harassment, even though it wasn't anything of the sort. And we went to the court hearing. It was like a 30-second court hearing, and I got remanded to Camp Adams until the Juvenile Detention Center had a bed open.
How long did you stay at Camp Adams?
I can't really tell you. Everything in between was 2 months total, a little bit over 2 months, but I kept getting switched from Camp Adams to the Juvenile Detention Center.
Just pay a child care?
Yeah. Okay. Every time that I was supposed to have a visit with my mom and my lawyer, I got switched. I never got either one.
What were you sentenced with finally once you got before internship?
Harassment, terroristic threats, and criminal conspiracy.
And you did 2 months ago?
Yeah.
Okay. How did that change you as a person? How did it change as a young person living in
this? Well, I never expected. I was never a bad guy. I never got in trouble before that at all. Nothing whatsoever. After I got out, I couldn't even go to school anymore for people thinking that I was so horrible. I stopped going to school and went to cyber school and stayed in there 4 years. Then I tried school for 6 months again, and same thing happened all over again. Suddenly I was like a bad person. I didn't really have many friends because of this. Everybody thought that I was a bad influence to be around. So in that instance, it kind of really upset me, because like I'm losing some friends, that possible really friends, didn't know. Or something that I didn't deserve. Okay.
What are you hoping the judge receives in this sentence?
My daughter.
I'd like life, but I really don't think it's gonna happen. I don't get my hopes up for this kid because he's been sent, well, not sentenced, but he's had court hearing how many times now, and he hasn't gone to jail. So I'm hoping for at least 15 to 20 years, at least.
But when we got that's kind of life.
Like
61,
yeah.
It's pretty close to life.
Yeah.
2 months. Do you hope to see him? Do you hope to say anything to him? Does he sleep in the courthouse?
I think if I saw him, I'd have to walk away. I'm that angry. I still hold this grudge against him. I don't think that I deserve what he did, especially for a 30-second hearing. Like, not even hearing my side of the story at all and just being put in shackles and taken away. I just want to see him put in check. I don't want him to be able to sit there and get his affairs done or say goodbye to people or anything.
Okay. Well, if it's stand up, why go in? I'll just wait for the years.
When the charges came down in 2009, were you and your family surprised
that he was being charged? Is that going to be for him breaking news?
Were you surprised that he was part of this grand scheme to allegedly send kids?
No, not at all. I wasn't surprised at all. With everybody that I met in juvenile detention and Camp Adams and hearing their stories and seeing people new come in every single day, it kind of just made me realize, like, okay, something's going on.
I'm going to run to the bathroom and stay here. Put me there and stay. I'll watch
you. It's what?
You're going to stay here? I already jammed from what he said.
Oh, I can imagine.
I'm just going to
breathe it on my house. Thank you. Good luck with everything. To come out and peacefully protest the sentencing?
No, he's from Pennsylvania. You know, no, this is going on. This is because of what Chivarella did to the kids. He gave 60 seconds out of there and sent the kid away, which is Chewbacca and everything.
Okay.
And, with the orange jumpsuits, the belt, the hook, the shackles, the cuffs, and everything. And he was convicted in February, and it's taken 6 months now. It was 60 seconds to send the kids away, 6 months for him to get sent. So we're here to make sure that he gets sent away today and get him off the street so he doesn't do any more harm to kids or anything in their lives.
And what town are you from, if I may ask?
I'm from Wyoming County.
Wyoming County?
Yeah, he's from Plains.
Okay. And you were out here during the trial as well, weren't you?
Yeah, I was out here during the trial.
Why has it been important to you to come out and be one of the people?
To keep people's awareness of what's going on, because after a period of time, a lot of people forget and everything, but we don't forget. I mean, this should be the last time. Better be. They should take them out of comfort today. No more deals and deals and show me mercy. They didn't show the kids any mercy.
Describe your outfit just a little bit for me. How are you dressed? Well, I know Chewbacca.
Yeah. Well, this is Clarker, like a Texas Ranger.
Okay. There.
You know, but, we don't fool around in Texas. We usually don't put this snow. We usually take them by.
Sure.
Yeah, I know. Don't put that
though. No.
But, we're here to just show our, I don't know what you would call it, discussing what's going on and everything. Our feeling, our hope is that he gets sent away cuffed and sent away. Let him do the appeals and not behind a jail cell, you know what I mean? Let them feel how the kids felt when they got sent away.
You mind if I talk to you real quick?
Go ahead.
Chewy? So you're one of the people that was sent away because of the sentencing standards. So what do you
think? Can I take this off for a while?
That's up to you. I mean,
yeah, you can't talk through that.
So what kind of thing were you sent? What did you serve?
I mean, it was my first offense ever. I got in an altercation, basically a fight.
Was it with a classmate?
No, it was with my kid's mother's newer boyfriend.
Okay.
It wasn't really even that much of an altercation. And like I said, it was my first offense. He kept me in there processing for 3 months in PA childcare. When usually they process you in like a couple days, you know what I mean? He just let the meter kept running, and then he sent me away for another 3 months. You know what I mean? It was my first offense ever. You know? So.
What do you think? What do you hope Chivarella's gonna be faced with when he's sentenced?
I hope we never have to see him again. With all the kids that he's hurt throughout the years, you know. How do we never see him again?
And why'd you choose the Chewbacca?
It's his thing. He does this year after year. You know what I mean? I really didn't have a chance to get out here because of work schedule and stuff like that. So I guess Chewbacca, that was my day. You know what I mean? I don't know.
You think justice is going to be served today in the sentence?
I sure hope so. You know what I mean? For America's sake. You know?
Have you met other victims like yourself?
Yeah.
Have you had a chance?
Oh, yeah.
What do they have to say about this whole process?
It's garbage. You know what I mean? It's really terrible that we let him go home time after time, spending time on his yacht, spending time with his family when he didn't give us a chance to spend time with our family.
He didn't give you a chance to say goodbye, right?
Yep.
When the charges came down in 2009, were you and your family in any way surprised that this was the allegation against that Judge Chivarella?
I can't believe what he got away with what he did as far as he got racketeering charges, I mean, but he's a horrible person for what he's done, you know what I mean?
Yeah. How old were you when you were sentenced?
I think like 17.
Okay. And you did 6 months combined between PA Child Care and your sentence?
Yep.
Was there in county prison?
No, I was up at PA Child Care.
And oh, okay. And then so in the juvenile center still?
Yeah, and okay. Then he sent me away to Clearbrook, which I think was another... he used to send people to like either Camp Adams,
right.
Clearbrook. I guess maybe they were in a scam. Who knows, man?
But you went to Clearbrook?
Yeah,
for your final 3 months.
I didn't even have a drug addiction or anything like that. You know what I mean? So, whatever.
Thank you for your time.
Thank you.
We appreciate it.
Thanks, yeah. There we go.